Hello. As you know, even though today wide-body aircraft are not uncommon, the space inside the cabin is still limited. Hence, when you travel, you can't take your entire wardrobe with you, nor your DVD collection, nor all your toddler's toys. Nonetheless, aeronautical engineers are constantly innovating so as to maximize cabin space usage. Thus, cabin layout is a major challenge to optimize every square centimeter to enable the stowage of luggage and optimal comfort for passengers and crew, while guaranteeing their safety. As you can imagine, every layout and configuration must respect aeronautical requirements. So every piece of equipment has to be extremely robust, yet as light as possible. An airline can choose to configure each of its aircraft cabins as it wishes. It usually chooses from among various pre-selected options offered by the aircraft manufacturers, like the seat model for each class. But as you will see, airlines can avail of a host of other options. So how about a little guided tour? First off, prior to boarding, you must check in your main suitcase so it can be stowed in the hold, which, as you know, is the area underneath the cabin into which the luggage is loaded. Though hold size may vary according to aircraft type, its proportions are standardized so as to facilitate the transport of suitcases, mail, or various kinds of merchandise, all of which is placed in specific containers. When you board the plane, your cabin and hand baggage will be stowed in the overhead bins above your seat. Although this space has already been optimized, Safran has developed new bins in which luggage can be placed edgewise, thus increasing the number of bags that can be carried in the cabin. Ah, at last, you can take your seat. As I mentioned earlier, the seat on which you are sitting has also undergone meticulous selection by the airline. It's such a strategic challenge that we have devoted an episode of SimplyFly to this topic alone, and I'd invite you to watch it after this one, of course. So now that the plane is airborne, I'm sure you've begun to feel a little hungry, no? If so, may I direct your attention to the section of the cabin located towards the front and towards the back called the galley. As its name suggests, the galley is where the flight attendants heat your meals and prepare your drinks. Fitted with various compartments, electrical appliances, and other accessories, the galley enables the storage of foodstuffs, the heating of food, its refrigeration, the serving of food and drinks to passengers, and the recycling of waste. Generally, the flight attendants use three or four ovens simultaneously to heat the meals that have been cooked or pre-cooked on the ground by an airline catering company. Each dish is delivered in an aluminum container with precise heating instructions. And thanks to the steam ovens used on today's aircraft, a dish can be heated in a matter of minutes. Now that you've had your meal, you might need to make a visit to the bathroom. Here, once more, everything is designed to be as compact and ergonomic as possible. Planes are equipped with increasingly high-tech toilets that can even be fitted with sensors that enable the user to flush the toilet, turn on the tap, and dispense soap without having to touch a thing. So, as you can see, with its cleverly designed interior, an aircraft can provide you with all the comforts you need, even at an altitude of 10,000 meters. Now that our little visit is over, ladies and gents, you can fasten your seatbelt and enjoy the rest of your trip. There, now you know everything, or nearly everything. But before we go, know that the cabin of the future will be a connected one. Thanks to overhead bins fitted with sensors and indicator lights, you'll be able to more easily locate available stowage space. Or you can use your smartphone to track your suitcase in the hold to make sure it's traveling beneath your feet.